This is AJ Jacobson with Rivals.com talking to Thomas Graham, TG4, right before the third game of the season. What you thinking about heading into this game?
Just kind of continue, at least in the corners room, just kind of continue our dominance on the outside and work our technique, focus on us. And based on like how our scheme is, as long as we control our man, control our side of the field, it's a good win for us and force them to go somewhere else.
What do you feel that the defensive back group needs to work on to get better at this point?
I just feel like we just need to stay consistent with our technique. We lack maturity, if you want to say that, just basically looking at the looking in black and white. But outside of that, I feel like that's the only thing we really lack is consistency. We have a lot of depth now, adding Javon Holland, Steven Stevens, Nick Pickett coming back, Brady Breeze coming back, and then with the corners, Khalif, adding Hockey, and Verone McKinley.
You're coming back as a starter, obviously, from last year. Did you ever feel pressure heading into this season that someone's breathing down your neck and take your job?
Yeah, I felt a lot of pressure, definitely at times, because at a time and point, definitely in spring, I had a slow start. I started spring off not what I wanted to. So the first 5 practices, it was just like I went home and I told my dad, I was just like, yeah, we gotta step it up. So I went home, worked out 2 times a day, came back, and I felt like I was a little better than what I came in at, and then just progressed from there.
What advice did Dad give you at that point?
He just told me, like, you just got to focus and be as hungry as you were when you first came in there. He was like, don't think just because you came back starting that they won't get somebody to replace you, because at a time point when you came in, there was another person starting over you that started the year before. So they're not recruiting somebody to come in and play behind you. They're recruiting somebody to take your job.
When you were not happy with your own play, what was your game plan for making yourself happy with your play?
It was really my mom helped me out. She just said focus on the little things, take it one day at a time. And so once I started doing that, taking a day at a time and start helping myself, like just improve individual little things, it was just like little things stacking on top of each other and create one big old thing.
It's great to have your parents, you know, be great mentors for you and all that. But what about on this team? Who's a mentor for you and who's helped you out here?
Person that helps me out here a lot in the coaching staff wise is Dante and Hayward. And Chris Ball stays on me. Chris Ball, he's been on me since he's got here. That's I wouldn't expect nothing else from him. And then player wise, I'll say any of the veterans that's been here last year, they've been on me since I got here and they haven't stopped. So Jalen Jelps, Troy Dye, Lana, Ugo, all of them I could run to for help find D2 on or off the field. And they make sure that I'm there, like, physically and mentally every day I practice, because if I'm not, then it's going to mess up us as a defensive unit progressing that day.
For sure. Hey, if you're not being a football player and you're not being a student, what do you do with your free time?
I play video games all the time.
What are you good
at? I play Madden. I'm the best Madden player on the team. Don't let Ugo lie to you, say he is.
Already said he was.
Ugo, to ask Ugo when's the last time he beat me, never. So we can go from there. But I'll say Madden and 2K, and then I don't really like the new Call of Duties, but I used to love Call of Duty.
Now, are you getting online and doing, you know, through the internet, or is it with buddies in the room?
I play with my Madden's usually buddies in the room. I sometimes play online. I just don't like it sometimes because it lags. But if anybody wants to add me, they can add me. My gamer tag is Lil TG. You feel me? I need as many people as I can to play with.
Why is Jux laughing at you right now?
Because I've been playing Fortnite with him, but he's always the one, the first one to die. So he laughs and acts like I'm the sorry one.
That's awesome. Sorry, go ahead.
Well, I was just going to ask about Adrian. Adrian Jackson making his first start. Can you reflect back to last year, making it, you know, what it's like making a start as a true freshman, kind of what you saw from him out there doing the same thing?
I see a lot of good in Adrian. I love seeing him pass rush. I know if he's out there, anybody, like any of our outside linebackers pass rush, and I know the quarterback got 2 seconds, and that's great for me because then I know certain routes cannot be ran. But to be a true freshman going out there, making your first start, it's scary. You go out there, Autzen Stadium, be scared to not make a mistake. Only thing I'll tell him, and I probably already told him, is don't go out there looking to make a mistake. Go out there and make a play. If you make a mistake, you make a mistake. But as long as you're going 1,000 miles per hour, that's all that matters.
What makes him a good pass rusher?
Makes him a good pass rusher. He's fast. He's strong. His strength is very deceiving. Like, he does not look as strong as he is. He's very strong. I didn't realize that until, like, we were watching film. One day he got duck of the day, and he did some pass rusher moves, and then he ended it with a bull rush. Uh-huh. And I think, I'm not sure, I think it was Stephen Jones, but this guy, one of our bigger offensive linemen, I was just like, yeah, very deceiving. He's like, to me, kind of reminds me of a younger Lamar. Very quick, very fast, good football IQ, And strength is very deceiving. You wouldn't expect him to be that small, but be able to set edges, be able to bully on linemen the way he does.
Do you feel like you guys have been tested in the passing game very much through two games? I mean, have guys challenged you deep as much as you would have expected?
They didn't challenge us deep as much as I would expect it, only because of that being our weakness last year.
Yeah.
Me, myself, too. That's one thing I prided myself on this offseason. It's not getting beat deep, but I'll say I feel like based on our technique and when we go over film that they had looked to try to throw it deep, but since we had good coverage, they just took the check down instead of that.
Is it something you find encouraging that you were able to maybe make them do things a little differently than they were hoping to?
Yes, it's very good. I'm very happy, actually, because that's something that we prided ourselves on through this whole offseason, at least in the corners room. Dante came and said that's the one big thing that we have to work on, and Coach Hayward already continues that. Coach Levitt preaches every day. And so that's the one thing we've been focusing on is playing low, being able to get in and out of our breaks and not get beat deep.